Hi everyone, Kira Beato here. Time to get back into Hogwarts Legacy. And hope that it loads quicker than last time. And the time before that. And the time before that. And the time before that. Oh, that's one thing we need to do. There we go. About right. Hopefully. Got my snack for while awake. This thing's messy. I got an apple pie from McDonald's. Okay.
Meet me in Lower Hogsfield as soon as possible. I would like to talk to you about Rookwood and Harlow, and it might be best to do so outside of the castle. Professor Fig and Weasley have asked that I teach you an additional defensive spell. Please complete the assignments I have given you, and then proceed to see me in my classroom.
Okay, let's go back to the map. I'm gonna go with that one first because it was the first one. Oops. Oh, it was an extra door I had to go through then. It's been very glitchy.
In there, I just know it.
Oh. Probably got me going on missions this one. Where are we going? Oh, that looks like Hagrid's hut. And there's the pumpkins.
This looks intriguing.
It is good to see you, my friend.
Hello, Natty. How are you? I hope you've recovered from our rather eventful trip to Hogsmeade.
I am well, but I have been worried about you, my friend. With Ranrock and Rookwood and Harlow after you?
I'm all right at the moment.
We did not speak about it at the time, but I am hoping now you might tell me why they were looking for you.
They want something that Professor Fig and I found at Gringotts.
When were you at Gringotts?
Just before we came to Hogwarts. In fact, it's why I was late to the sorting ceremony. A portkey brought us there after the dragon attacked our carriage.
What on earth?
There's one more thing. It's a bit odd, if I'm honest. Professor Fig says I have a rare connection to a powerful form of ancient magic.
Is that the magic you used fighting the trolls in Hogsmeade?
I think so. I'm still learning, but I can see traces of it, and a class magic I can't otherwise explain. I know that's a lot to absorb.
It is. And I will have more questions. For now, it is safe to say that Rookwood and Harlow are a threat to both of us, to all of us. Which is why I wanted to speak to you. I realized something that day in Hogsmeade. You displayed such courage fighting that troll. And Serona wasn't intimidated one bit by Rookwood and Harlow. Both of you have inspired me to take a stand of my own.
What sort of stand?
Men like Rookwood and Harlow are the reason my mother and I left Matibililand. I am not going to sit by and watch them destroy my new home.
Good. Rookwood and Harlow are a dangerous pair. And the fact that they're working with Ranrock, well...
All the more reason they must be stopped. Rumor has it that Theophilus Harlow runs Rookwood's day-to-day operations. Taking him down would cripple Rookwood's entire enterprise.
That may be true, but shouldn't Officer Singer handle someone like Harlow?
I spoke with her. She was polite, but perhaps understandably would not discuss details with a student. I overheard some of Rookwood's lot talking about a massive poaching operation that Harlow was planning. I was thinking that we could investigate a bit. Try to get the evidence that Officer Singer needs.
All right. But how?
I am going to watch and listen, find out precisely what Harlow is up to. I shall reach out when I know more. In the meantime, remember, I am here if you need me.
Thank you, Natty.
Be on your guard.
What's going on here?
I was gonna go check it out anyway. Buttons aren't working properly.
This way. Think!
I've no idea who it is you think I might have seen. I've been busy with my research. I do not have time.
Victor Rookwood don't give a doxy's nip about your time. Oi! Speak of the devil. Mr. Rookwood would like a word with you.
A student! You can't be
sick! Enough out of you.
Leave her alone.
Stupid man!
Just happened. I've never been accosted in such a manner, and so close to Hogwarts.
Let's just say Quick save. And hopefully it will stop glitching.
Are you alright?
I am, thanks in no small part to your excellent defensive skills. Care to tell me why two Ashwinders were ready to dispatch me to get to you?
Ashwinders?
Victor Rookwood's thieves and extortionists, his little cronies. They seemed quite keen on you.
It's a long story, but thank you for your help.
Well, you've avoided them for the moment. Priya warned me things were getting dangerous. Best get moving on my research before they return.
You're a researcher.
Nora Treadwell at your service. Historian and archaeologist specializing in Merlin's work and life.
Merlin? Of the legend of King Arthur?
The very same. Merlin attended Hogwarts, you know, and I'm studying some curious fixtures he left here centuries ago.
Fixtures?
These vine-covered pillars, dozens of them, all around the area. I've taken to calling them the Trials of Merlin. I believe he created them as a diversion for his fellow Slytherins. He was terribly fond of puzzles and enigmas.
I can see why you're so interested in Merlin. I'd be keen to know more about the trials.
Well then, I'll let you in on a little secret. No one has yet managed to figure out how they work. But I believe I have just unlocked a crucial clue. I suspect that mouse suit is an important component in getting the trials to work.
Mallow suit?
Versatile herb. Merlin repeatedly mentioned it in his writings. I had just arrived to test my theory when I was so rudely interrupted. You see, each swirl in Merlin's writing has a symbol in the center. That started me thinking, what if...
Mallow sweet is meant to be placed at the center of the symbols.
Precisely. Would you care to do the honors? We can see what comes of our little hypothesis. I brought a trunk chock full of mallow sweet with me. It's just over there by my tent.
This trunk?
Yes, take plenty, even if you already have some.
I have the mallow sweet.
Lovely. Now, notice the vines on these pillars here, as well as a stone swirl on the ground. Each trunk has these features. Place the mallow sweet on the swirl, and we'll see what happens.
How do we do that? Oh.
My word! Did you see that? The vines disappeared!
What should I do now?
This is uncharted territory. I am curious about these pies.
Lumos. Let me open.
These are pyres, after all.
Merlin's bit! The flames make the pyre sink.
Curious. The pyres are back where they started.
Incendio!
all three of these fires are meant to be lit. It seems the pyres sink if you don't light the others quickly enough.
Incendio. You have to be quite close to him as well.
Today, I can hardly believe it. Lumos. I take it we can call that a success.
We can indeed. However, I now have even more questions. How does it work? I must review my notes. I may have missed something.
Are all of the trials like this one?
Hmm? Oh, not precisely. Well, I think each has those telltale vines and the swirl on the ground. You should feel free to solve them as you come across them. I believe I have what I need to continue my research. My guess is that each will also require mallow suit, which you can find in Hogsmeade should you need more. I really must be off. Such a pleasure to meet you. And do be careful out here. Now, I've got what I needed. I shall return to the safety of my notes and books. Here.
Okay. Let's click save again. Time to go on a mooch again. I think it's gone darker. I don't know if it's the game or if it's because I unplugged it. Okay, it must be the game. Try not to keep my finger on the button for too long. I just did that.
Good morning, Professor Garlic. How wonderful it is to see you again, Lenora dear. Oh, here. You'll need these for today's class. A little treat for your auntie. Welcome the newest rose in our garden. We do look forward to growing together. How thrilling it is to have everyone back together again. This year will be filled with enchantment and excitement, but the most important thing cultivated in herbology is knowledge. The prudent herbologist is no more afraid of the venomous tentacular than the bouncing bomb. Now then, today we will be acquainting ourselves with the mellifluous tuber known as the mandrake root. Accio. Let's see if
we can
make
our friends
a bit more comfortable, shall we? First, let's protect our ears.
I turned it down.
Now, everyone, grip the mandrake by the tendrils and give it a tug. Should envelop the root like a warm, dirty blanket, putting the mandrake right at ease. Repairer! I'm very sorry about that. Yours was a bit mature, I'm afraid. All right then, off you go. Splendid work, everyone! Now for our next task,
we'll be planting dittany at our potting table.
Hmm. I wonder if hippogriffs like mock grass.
Yes, Professor?
Firstly, well done with your mandrake. They can be rather difficult to get a grasp of.
I'll say, I nearly went deaf.
Well, yes. Of course, the cry of a mature mandragora can be fatal, so remember to keep those ears protected. Now, as I mentioned, next we'll be planting dittany. Let us find you some seeds.
I already have some, Professor. Picked them up in Hogsmeade.
You visited the Magic Neep. Wonderful! A prepared student is bound to bloom. I've arranged for you to have your own potting table here in the classroom. Wasn't easy to spare one on such late notice. Plant the seeds there now, and you can return to harvest them later. Even with soil, sunlight, and a bit of magic, they will take time to grow.
Let's see how to balance my star thistle arrangement. Nifflers fancy, or roses?
Dittany's restorative properties make it a vital ingredient in the Wiganweld potion, as you all should know from Professor Sharp's class.
Well done! Once it can be harvested, your dittany will be ready to use in Wiganweld potion. I'll let Professor Sharp tell you about that. Now, what say we branch out? Introduce you to a different sort of flora, the Chinese chomping cabbage.
You'll find that some plants are better suited to uses outside of a cauldron.
The cabbages do get testy without something to chew. Fortunately, I have a dummy for them to gnaw on. Be a dear, and let them have a good chomping.
Yes, Professor.
They're in the other greenhouse. It's just at the end of the footbridge leading out of this room. Your classmate, Mr. Pruitt, has kindly offered to accompany you. Come back and see me when you're finished. Oh, and mind your fingers. They do bite.
Okay.
Hello. Saw you on your way to Hogsmeade the other day. Nice to meet you. I'm Leander. I'll be showing you the Chinese chomp. Nice work in Defense Against the Dark Arts, by the way.
Excuse me?
Your duel with Sebastian. And he's good. Thinks he's really good. But you outright slaughtered him. It was brilliant.
Oh, well, thank you.
I nearly put Sebastian in his place myself. I mean, I would have, if Hecate hadn't stopped me.
Didn't she stop that dragon skull from crushing you?
Here we are. Home of the Chinese chomping cabbage. Go on, grab a few of those cabbages. Just mind your fingers. I almost lost a thumb. Don't worry, Nurse Blaney put it back on. Trust me, you do not want to go through that. Now, see that dummy? Just toss the cabbages at it, and they'll do the rest.
Hold tab. Oh. Not working. There we go.
Look at that. They'll chomp on anything they can get their mouths on. Mum planted some in her garden last year to keep the gnomes out. Did save her the denoming, but they left her honking daffodils in tatters. Vicious little bastards, aren't they? My kind of plants. Not like stupid booba tubers and bouncing bulbs. The kind of plants that just have your back in a fight. Not saying you can't go it alone, but, well, imagine that wasn't a dummy.
I suppose they could prove useful outside of the greenhouse. Nothing wrong with a bit of backup.
even if it is from a cabbage.
It's chaos out there. Trolls in Hogsmeade and such. You can't be above throwing a cruciferous vegetable if necessary. Dogweed and Deathcap has more of them, if you're keen. Other plants too. Ones your parents wouldn't plant in the garden. You get the idea. Anyway, we probably ought to head back to class. Take your time. I'll see you back in class.
Reminder as to why we should always wear our dragon hide gloves. I shall end our lesson here.
I attended to the Chinese chomping cabbages, Professor.
Remarkable plants, aren't they? I hope they weren't too much trouble. Oh, don't see any bite marks or missing digits. And good, as you do seem to be quite green-fingered. Oh, I'm eager to see your skill in the soil continue to blossom.
Magical plants have so much to offer. I'm eager to learn more.
I'm glad. Herbology is a bounteous subject. Tend to your garden, and it will tend to you. Huh. Well, I suppose that's everything. Do come by for a chat sometime. I so enjoy checking in with my new students.
Okie dokie. Minutes in. Anyway, thanks for watching. Stay tuned and toodaloo, mofos.